How's life on the road been for you?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun, good friends, playing poker, having a good life. Pretty baller. It's nice.
If I'm in one place for too long, I start to get a little restless. So maybe I have a little bit of a gypsy soul, which helps me. I don't know.
What's the hardest thing for you when you're on the road?
I'm getting a little bit homesick at the minute. I'm looking forward to going home.
On the road, I do miss home a lot. I miss our friends, my family, and everything. And just having like the small things, like not having your own bed, is pretty big.
The hardest thing is when you get sick, because it's just when you're not home and you're not feeling good, it's just really, really brutal.
It's very hard when you're in a bad location and you're not having fun. The main thing is to have fun and keep poker entertainment and relaxing. You don't want too much stress.
It's definitely just not having continuity, not having one place that you can call your own that is like truly restful, and it's like your nest that you've built.
I think it's maybe a bit harder to have a social life, like, you know, getting married, getting kids, meeting the right person, everything, because you're always moving from one country to another.
I guess just keeping in contact with like friends and family at home, so they always get annoyed with me and my like parents that I'm never talking to them, so probably that.
Like eating well and cheaply. If you want to eat really well, you have to spend a lot of money. Like, and just, you can't get into a rhythm, you know. I'm so lazy when I'm on the road. I never work out, I never do anything. So that's like the hard thing, but at the same time, it's so much fun. I wouldn't trade it.
Probably sleep pattern and trying to get fit as well. I'm actually trying to go to the gym quite a lot. And when you're traveling all the time, like, you've never got energy. It's hard to keep your energy levels high enough to like go to the gym and eat well. When you've got tournaments as well, it's hard to like keep it all together.
Do you usually stay in apartments or hotels?
Normally hotels. Even though like we've hired a villa a few times, and like that's been great because it's like actually works out cheaper as well.
We're staying in an apartment actually on this occasion. Usually it's been hotels, but I think this is the way to go. It's so cheap. It's like €300 each per week.
I definitely like to share apartments more because I enjoy being able to, well, maybe not me cook, but eat home-cooked meals.
I'd much rather stay in houses and apartments or whatever than a hotel, but that's kind of why I don't like going to the tournaments, because there's not a lot of options and I always decide to go late. But this one's good because you've got a nice house and been here for a couple of weeks, so it's a holiday more than a poker tournament.
Do you like staying in the villas and apartments or hotels?
I think you have to as a poker player, otherwise you'd spend a fortune on hotels. I'm paying like €400 for a week here, and it's just so much better than paying like €400 per night in Cannes.
Hotels are nice, you know, it's easy. You don't have to do anything, people clean your room for you, and just hassle-free. Yeah,
I think it's actually kind of helpful to share with other players, and I mean, we're all friends, so it really helps that the guys you can like say hands to and bounce our plans off.
I enjoy hanging out, and it's nice to have some roommates sometimes when you're traveling. It's nice to have the camaraderie of some work colleagues.